Okay, so this is an example of a problem that we're going to solve using induction. It says prove that the infinite sum of 1 over n times n plus 1 equals n over n plus 1 for all n in the natural numbers. So like what I wrote here, this is just kind of writing out the thinking process. So we're going to prove using induction. And when we do that, the first thing we need to prove is that the base case holds. So in this case, the base case is when n equals 1 because it just has to be in the natural numbers. So when n equals 1, we have 1 over 1 times 1 plus 1, which equals 1 over 2. So that's for the left-hand side. And then for the right-hand side, we have 1 over 1 plus 1, which again equals 1 over 2. So we have that 1 half equals 1 half, or that the left-hand side equals the right-hand side. Thus, the base case holds. Next comes the inductive hypothesis, which is just you're basically assuming that the equality holds for some n equals k. So I usually write assume for some or any n equals k in n that the equality holds. So we have 1 over k times k plus 1 equals, that's kind of a weird one, equals k over k plus 1. So assume that that holds true, then the inductive step when n equals k plus 1, we have this left hand side 1 plus 1 times 1 plus 1 plus blah 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 plus 1 over k times k plus 1 plus 1 over k plus 1 times k plus 1 plus 1, and that equals the right hand side, which is going to be k over k plus 1 plus 1 over k plus 1 times k plus 1 plus 1. So we're using the inductive hypothesis in this step by plugging in k plus 1 to this part of the equation and then adding it to this equation. So we're assuming that this is true, that this infinite sums equals k over k plus 1. Then the infinite sum of k plus, when we're taking the term k plus 1 and including it in the infinite sum, then that equals the infinite sum of k plus this part, which is k plus 1. Okay, so then we just need to simplify the right-hand side and get it to look like something that we know is true. So we're going to combine the two fractions. So that's going to be k times k plus 2 plus 1 over k plus 1 times k plus 2. So we basically want it to look like k plus 1 over k plus 1 plus 1 to be able to say that induction holds. So let's go ahead and distribute. So we're going to get k squared plus 2k plus 1. That's going to be over k plus 1 times k plus 2. Well, k squared plus 2k plus 1 can be factored as k plus 1 times k plus 1 over k plus 1 over k times k plus 2. That cancels out. So we have k plus 1 over k plus 1 plus 1, which is the form of the right-hand side for any n, or any n equals k. So we know that that's true. So we've basically proved the whole problem. Thus, the equality holds for n equals k plus 1. So now we can say, thus, by the principle of mathematical induction, we know that 1 over 1 times 1 plus 1 plus 1 over k times k plus 1 equals k over k plus 1. Or sorry, these should be n's. N holds true, and this time it's for all n in n.